in summary, we have seen that loyalty programs cannot definitively modify behavior. That's a dream that cannot be achieved. So marketing is doing only temporarily well, as Aaron Beck stated. Marketers must do hard to stand still. And this is valid for loyalty programs. And so you cannot expect to change dramatically purchase behaviors. But customers are characterized by very strong patterns of habits because they like inertia. Being loyalty programs don't expect that you will change fundamentally the market. But they are, at least in the offline markets, the only tool to get customer data. Because the real challenge is there behind the big data manager. For effectiveness profits, that is personalization, and for value aligning, they are really useful. So this is the first statement. The second statement is when raising up loyalty programs, you should consider a certain number of variants. First of all, it is important to elaborate an attractive reward program based on different tools, such as the time, such as the compatibility, such as tangibility, and within that, have to consider the different dimensions of value: economic, hedonistic, relational, social, altruistic value, that you can offer, dependent on the customers you're operating with. So it's important to understand what customers are really searching for. That is why you have to determine what customers want before operating a program. You should ask them about the preferences, and you can then scan customer behavior in order to see what they prefer. So with the time, with the history, you can learn about customers and then personalize also relationship and the reward management of the loyalty program. Second, more effectiveness profits and value alignment objectives. And third, there are sectors which are more appropriate, service sectors. And if not service sectors, you should focus more on rewards which are immaterial. Privileges, services, status, relationships, which are not too expensive compared to simple monetary rewards. So, and service sectors are more appropriate than retail sectors. There are markets which are more appropriate. And so if you're a market leader, it makes more sense to raise a loyalty program than if you're a follower because of double jeopardy. And if you want to launch a program, then you have to really think about differentiation. What is your niche position compared to market leader position? So consider double jeopardy. And finally, there are actually firm characteristics. If you're a low-cost leader or a cost dominator, then it probably makes no sense to engage into loyalty programs or any other customer relationship marketing management tool. Talking about differentiation, then it makes sense. Then the differentiation comes through the relationship, the privileged relationship you're establishing with the customer, through the personalization you're doing with the customer, and all this brings differentiation for the customer and might become the main reason why the customer chooses your brand. In summary, heterogeneity of customers is an important fact. When customers are very heterogeneous, it is important to have customer data to serve them differently. If you have homogeneous customers, it does not make sense. Also consider the behavior in order to see, to differentiate programs according to different tiers. Even in retail sector, it makes sense to have different cards. For example, create one VIP card for your top customers and one normal card. Give special status, special privileges, special services only to the VIP customers. In summary, there's not one single loyalty program. There are different loyalty programs. And only imitating competitors is not an issue. So a loyalty program should be operated exactly according to the sector difference. It should be operated according to the customers you're having. It should be operated according to if you're a retail or service. It should be operated if you're a leader or a follower. And so what you should have retained are the different design characteristics, and so tangible, intangible with the different value dimensions, economical, hedonistic, functional, information, and relational. Can include also altruistic motivations. You should consider the time, and you should know what types of objectives you want to pursue: efficiency profits, effectiveness profits, or value alignment. And you should again consider moderating factors such as expectations of customers, markets, and firm characteristics.